I tried this n8n AI SEO blog writing agent for 100 days. In this video, I'll be sharing with you the exact results I've gotten. The website I'm trying to rank is actually for my own AI automation agency. Everything is actually from this AI agent that is created by this guy called Productive Dude. And a disclaimer here, I am not an SEO expert, right? I copied this SEO template from this YouTuber. I've managed to rank for a new site for keywords that are relevant to my niche. Probably not the best, but I don't think this is like absolutely terrible. Currently, I'm ranking for this term AI Automation Agency Singapore, and I'm at the 5th position. In terms of other terms I'm ranking for, not so good. The position is like at 30 to 40. Within a period of 100 days, I've gotten about 2 to 3 leads, of which I would say it's verified. Some of these leads are actually from startups who have raised millions of dollars. I've actually gotten another lead from a company, and their domain is only 4 letters. These are big companies that are reaching out to me. Have I closed them? Not really. I'm still in the midst of discussing in terms of what I can create for them. This is just part of me sharing my journey when it comes to growing my n8n automation agency. I think many people look down on AI SEO. Am I saying that these are the best results? Not really, but I think that this is really getting to somewhere, especially for a person like me who is just in the early days of starting my AI automation agency. For the remaining part of this video, I'll just be sharing the specifics of what this workflow comprises of. Step one, first, tell what keywords you want the SEO AI agent to optimize for. So the keyword I really want to optimize for is, what is an n8n automation agency? This excludes the competitiveness of the keyword, but I just want to demonstrate how I'll use it. This is the keyword I want to rank for. And the thing I like about this workflow, there's actually a feedback loop that can happen. I'm sure I'm not the only one who have watched a lot of SEO AI agents n8n and tried a lot of n8n templates. There are some workflows, in my opinion, are like too crazy. This is where I would have a conversation with it in terms of trying to get an outline from it. So yeah, this is step two, where the SEO AI agent will then provide you with a blog outline. This is where it's important for you to provide feedback based on your preference, ideally adding a human touch to it, and be opinionated, add some personal relevant experience into the blog content. Usually the first outline it gives you, it's pretty okay. It's always best to put a little bit of yourself in the blog post. Let me try. Can you put some analogy at the very start of the blog post? Mentioning AI is often a buzzword. n8n automation agency is also another new shiny thing where people don't understand. Sometimes people have ridiculous expectations of what can do. I have plenty of conversations with business owners who think that automation agency can literally replace their business. And in this case, being a person who is very familiar with n8n, I would say that's actually not the case. It can get you somewhere there. It's not at a point where it can literally do everything, right? You need to compartmentalize what you need. Maybe I can just deviate a little bit, right? This is why I wrote this blog post, right? The AI automation trap when boring is better for your business. I wrote this in the frustration of talking to many business owners which think that AI agents can do everything. It's really not the case. You need to be very specific. At the end of the day, I think when it comes to the agency space, right, you don't want to overpromise. In general, you want to underpromise and overdeliver, right? So it's not a good situation if they come in and expect the sky and the moon and you're not even able to deliver minimally of what they expect. So that's where I think it's very important to set expectations up front. These are the personal things that I want to put in. I think the more feedback you give it, the better the blog post would be. For the sake of this video, let's say I'm happy with this. Once you're satisfied with the outline, you can ask it to generate the SEO article in full HTML with SEO best practices. Let me elaborate a little bit about these notes over here. It pulls past articles from your website. It pulls your preferences. It pulls keywords that you want to rank for. I'm currently using this database, which is NocoDB, an open source Airtable alternative. And you can see your keywords here. Basically, if you tell it a keyword that you want to rank for, it can store it for you. And these are proven titles that I've actually copied from this YouTuber called Nicholas Cole. He's a Quora writer who have written a lot of these templates, and these titles have worked for him. You can also include some preferences. The objective of all these notes, right, is to actually provide the LLM as much context as possible. Based on the prompt I'm using, right, the first part of it is, you are a blogging assistant representing Osinity, which is the current website I'm trying to optimize for. Then this paragraph here elaborates on what the brand is, and your primary role is to help create blog posts. I've tailored the workflow specifically for me because many people out there use Shopify, Webflow, WordPress. These are platforms where you can actually automate your blog posts to be published on. For myself, I have a slightly different workflow because I actually hard code my website. Basically, what I need is a full HTML, CSS blog article that is ready to be copy-pasted into my VS Code. So the workflow overview, I would argue, is probably the most important thing. Discuss blog ideas, brainstorm relevant topics for the user, draft an outline, and then publish the post. Another thing that would be useful is to insert backlinks, insert relevant in-links, backlinks from the following list when it fits naturally into the content. I've also created a blog database of every single blog title, the summary, keyword that's optimized for, and the URLs of what has been published before. So I know I'm not an SEO expert, but I know you need to internally link your blog posts with one another. Other things in this AI agent, there are current preferences that I've included here, the current meta keywords for the entire site, and the proven blog title templates. For context, I'm using Gemini 2.0 Flash, but I think I can definitely experiment it with 2.5 Flash or even ChatGPT Grok. I'm more of a fan of optimizing what you can on the prompt layer before you even try use different LLMs, because I think that if you give it very good instructions, and I'm not saying this is the best instructions, right, but you need to tailor it based on the outcome that you want, right? So let's say I want the length of the blog post to be about 1.5 to 2,000 words. I need it to be in full HTML, CSS. You need to adjust the prompt based on what you need and what is specific of what you want to achieve. The HTML is ready. I'll copy paste it into my VS Code and I'll open it with a live server to see how the content is, right? So let's assume I'm just happy with all these content. So something I like to do is actually to put external links. And if there are more external links I can put, right, I think that would usually be better. Sometimes I will even link it to competitors. These companies are already ranking very well for these keywords, right? So I want to like just copy aspects of content to try increase my chances to rank properly. Quite strange here, right? You say according to a Zapier survey, 88% of business owners, but when I try to create on this link, this page is not available. So this is a little bit suspicious, right? But what I'll usually do is just click around and literally just command A, command C, and go back to my workflow and say that this is a company currently ranking for the keyword I want. Adjust my content. Yep, these are things that you can do. And that's the reason why I love this back and forth conversation with this SEO AI agent, because it's sort of talking to like an employee of sorts, but it really adjusts things to what I want. Okay, let's assume I'm just happy with it. And there's actually an image that I need to put over here. I'm just happy to use any copyright free photos. Okay, maybe let's just use this image. I feel it's a bit ironic when I'm doing this because I'm not fully automating the process, right? But at the same time, I'm not spending a lot of time doing this. I think maybe I can take about 15 minutes to 20 minutes per blog post. What we need to do next is then update our sitemap.xml and then submit it on Google Search Console. So that's typically the process of what I'm doing when it comes to SEOing my current website.